Hello and welcome to today's Daily Market Update with me, Josh Mahoney, Research Analyst here at Alpari UK. Now, mixed messages out of the market this morning. I mean, we have got the UK FTSE 100 indices trading higher. However, the rest of the European indices, along with those US futures, are trading lower. Now, of course, the sentiment at the moment really is driven by what is happening over in the US in terms of the negotiations over a budget and also over the debt ceiling. Now, the debt ceiling is going to run out, or it's going to be reached within around about 3 days on the 17th of October. And if they do not find a resolution before then it's going to be all sorts of trouble. Now, what we are looking at is potentially it would pull the rest of the countries in the major economies back into recession, in the words of the IMF chief Christine Lagarde over the weekend. And so it is very critical that they do actually find a resolution to this. Now, some of the talks over the weekend have been positive in terms of the fact that they have been taking place. However, it seems like they do seem to be as far apart on the issues. Now, we do see the Republicans trying to put forward more short-term measures, especially in relation to the debt ceiling. However, the Democrats are looking to sort of include some of the elements in terms of the current government shutdown. And really, it seems like they're both poles apart as it stands. We only have a few days left. And so really, at the moment, everyone's looking towards whether they're going to find a resolution as to where the markets are really looking to go. Now, also over the weekend, we did get these Chinese trade balance figure come out. Really, we were looking at the export and import figures for a little bit more clarity as to how it is developing going forward. Now, of course, we have seen some resurgent strength out of the Chinese region recently, and so we were expecting a positive export figure. However, it did fall into negative territory, contracting by 0.3% in September. And really, that was a pretty big shock to the markets. However, when you do look at this, really, I mean, we have spoken many months ago about the overstatement of some of the invoices over in the Chinese region. And really, this does seem to be playing into the sort of calculation of these figures somewhat, because last year they were overinflated figures. And that's not to say that this year's figures aren't good, it's just to say that they are more in line with what is actually the case at the moment. And subsequently, yes, it does point to a decrease on a year-on-year figure, but given that the previous figures weren't a true representation of the exports in the country, I don't think it's necessarily a bad thing. Now, looking at the imports figure, it did rise above expectations, and in essence, what we were looking at really was the iron ore figure, because it was the highest absolute level of iron ore that they've imported into China in history. And that has really provided a pretty significant boost to the Australian economy in particular, because that's one of their major and most valuable exports to China. And we have seen the Australian dollar rally off the back of that in today's session. Now, also, we did see the Chinese CPI figure rise above expectations. We were expecting it to remain at 2.8%. It did go to 3.1%. And really, that does have an effect upon some of the stimulus measures that the PBOC over in China would be able to enact. And it does limit them somewhat. So that's pretty notable in itself. For the rest of the session, there's not really too much going on to look out for. So again, people are really going to be looking out of some of the tones coming out of the US and whether there's going to be any sort of breakthrough in negotiations. So that's it for today, guys. If you want any more news and analysis, come and check out the Alpari newsroom at alpari.co.uk/newsroom, or check me out on Twitter. My name's Joshua Mahoney, research analyst here at Alpari UK. Have a great day.